Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about singly linked list and different operations which are associated with singly linked list. Okay, so let's move ahead. So first, what is linked list? What is linked list? That we can say it as a singly linked list. So it is a linear data structure like an array, but there is a difference between two. We will discuss it afterwards. Elements or nodes are linked with each other using a pointers. In singly linked list, traversal is unidirectional. That means each and every node will have a single pointer which will just point in forward direction. It can be dynamically expanded. No need to specify maximum size, that is a upper limit. This is what is the biggest difference between linked list and array. Linked list is very easy for insertion and deletion of new elements. Now these are the few terms which are related with singly linked list. Each element in a linked list is called as node. A single node contains two things. One is a data and next node and pointer to the next node. As we had discussed in previous slide that every node is linked with node is linked with pointers and every node has a forward directional pointer. Okay, so here you can see in this example, this is a single node which has a two elements. One is a data and other one is a data pointer, which will point to the next node. First node in a singly linked list is called as a head. So this is nothing but first node, which is a head. And last node points to the null because there are no more nodes further. So the node pointer will point to the null. Now, what are the different applications of singly linked list? It is used in representation of a graph in adjacency list format. Different operations on the polynomials can be performed by storing the constants in the node of linked list. It is used to implement the other data structures like stack and queue. It is much more useful in the dynamic memory allocation to keep track of free memory blocks. So whenever you are performing dynamic memory allocation, so whatever are the free blocks in your memory that can be linked to each other using a singly linked list. Now these are the few different common singly linked list operations which we are going to implement, which we are going to discuss the pseudocode for those operations. So first is adding a new node to the list. Now there are different ways by which we can add the node to the list. We can add it at the first position. We can add it at the last position. That it will be, we can append it to the list. Then we can add after a specific node. Okay. Then we can delete a node. We can display all the nodes. That is nothing but displaying all the nodes means nothing but the traverser of the list from start to end. Okay. Now we will move to the implementation of singly linked list and different operations which can be done on a singly linked list. First, we will declare one C data structure. We will declare one C structure for a node in the linked list. So the name of that structure is nothing but the struct node, and it will have two elements. One is a data and other one is a pointer. That pointer is nothing but it is again the type of struct node, because this pointer is going to point to the next node, and that node will be again, it will be the type of this struct node. Okay, so here you can see the sample list has been shown, data next, and there are four nodes in this particular singly linked list. Now first we will discuss the code of insertion of a new node at the first position, so at the head position. Okay, so here you can see that we have first declared a global variable to start to store the start of linked list. As we had previously discussed, the first node of a linked list is called as a head node or a start node. Okay, now after that, in case of an insert node at first, we have created one temporary node. We have accepted the value which need to be inserted, and that value has been stored in that particular temporary node in data element. After that, the next element of that temporary node will point to the null. Okay, then we will check that whether your linked list is empty or not. If it is empty, that means whatever node you are going to add is going to be first node or the only node in your list, then your head node will point to that particular temporary node. Else what you have, what is there is temp to the next is equal to head. That means this next pointer of your temp node will point to the head node, and that particular temporary node will become head node. Okay. Now the next is function to append the node at the list. Okay. Now here you can see is we need to add this particular temporary node at the end of the list. So we will just traverse the list starting from head. So you can see this T is getting incremented, T to the next, T to the next, and it is pointing to the next node till the next of this particular T is not null. And once it will become null, then this temporary node will be added as a T to the next. Okay, so again here also first we will accept the value which need to be inserted, we will store it, we will create one temporary node which is nothing but a temp node, and we will store that particular value in your temporary node. After that, if your list is empty, then this particular temporary node will become your head node, else you need to keep on traversing till the end of the list. Okay, so for that T is equal to T to the next. This particular statement helps you to travel to the next node, and for how much time you need to do it until T of next pointer is not null. Okay, and after that, whenever you get this particular condition, whenever you have reached to this condition where T of next is equal to null, that time you need to add this particular temporary node as the next node of T. Now, what if you need to add the node after a specific node value? Suppose now this is nothing but temp new is nothing but a new node which you need to be added in between these two nodes, temp and temp of next. Okay, so for that, the next pointer of temp will point to temp of new, and next pointer of temp of new will point to the temp of next. So let's see the pseudocode for that. So first we have accepted the value after which you need to add the data, and value underscore new, this variable will store the new value which you need to be inserted. Again, we have allocated the memory for temp underscore new. Okay, and this new value we have stored into temp underscore new. We have checked whether our list is empty or not. If list is empty, then we cannot insert a node in between. Okay, if there are already few nodes are there, then we can perform the operation of inserting a node in between. So here temp is equal to head, and if temp of data is equal to value, what we will do is we will keep on traversing the list till the time we will get the value after which we need to insert our value. Okay, so here you can see we are just doing the traversal of the list, and whenever we will get that after which data we need to insert our new value, whenever we will reach to that particular point, then what we have done is temp of new next is equal to temp of next, temp of new next is equal to temp of next, and temp of next is equal to temp of new, and we will break, so it will come out of this do while statement. Okay, and this traversal we have do till we will reach to the end of the list. Once we have reached to the end of the list and we couldn't find the value after which we need to insert the new value, then we can display a message that whatever is the required node after which you need to insert the new value is not found. Okay, now what if you need to delete a node? In case of a deletion, we always need to keep track of the previous node. Okay, so here you can see that this is a head node, previous, and the current node. Fine. So your current node is pointing to the head. We are incrementing the current, and previous, this prev, you can see it is keeping track of the previous node. Okay, so this previous will point to the next of the current. Fine. So we will see the pseudocode. Again, you need to accept the value of a node which need to be deleted. Here we need to maintain two pointers. One is a current and the previous. Okay. Now, current is pointing to the head and previous is pointing. Currently, it is pointing to the null. But what it will point is, it will point to the previous of your current node. Okay, so whatever value will be there in the current, its previous value will be present in prev. Okay. So if head of data is equal to value, that means whatever value you need to be deleted is present at the head node, then you will change the location of your head node. Okay. And here always keep it in the mind, once you delete that particular element, or once you change the reference of the next pointer for that node which you need to be deleted, then you need to free the memory allocated for that particular node. Okay, so if it is not at the first node, then what you will do is you will just keep on traversing the list, but just keep it in the mind that whenever you are traversing through the list, you need to keep reference of a previous node in this particular prev node. So if current data is equal to value, that means you have found that particular node where you need to perform the deletion, or the node which you need to delete, then previous next is equal to current next. That means this previous is nothing but it is that particular node which is previous to the current. So this previous node will point to the current's next node. Okay, like that you need to keep on traversing the list until cur is not equal to null. One more thing is, if the value to be deleted is not available in any of the node, then you need to display the message that node does not exist in the list. Okay, the finally is a very simple operation, which is nothing but display of the list, which is nothing but traversing the list. Okay, so here your temp will point to the head node, and you just need to keep on traversing the list using temp is equal to next. Okay, so using the next pointer, you just need to keep on traversing the list and keep on displaying the data until temp is equal to none. Okay, this is what is the expected output. Here first we have added the nodes 10 and 20. After that we have again added the node 30, but this time we have added the node 30 at the first position. So here we have changed the head pointer. Okay, after that what we have done is we have tried to insert the node that is a 40 after a particular value. So after 10 we have added value as a 40. Then what we have done is we have deleted the node whose value is 30, and again we have tried to display the list to check whether our deletion has been successful or not. So this was the what is expected from you. Again, in this program also you have to use the switch case. So in main function you will keep on calling all those functions which perform the different operations on the linked list. So these are the few test cases. Try to delete the first node or last node of the list. Try to delete a value which is not present in the node. All these test cases we have already discussed whenever we were discussing the pseudocode. Thank you.